Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to create this spur gear assembly and animation in SOLIDWORKS. First we will create this shaft and pin separately, then in the assembly we will create both the gears, and after that we will assign this animation. I hope you like it. So let's start to see this one, how to create this beautiful animation and assembly in SOLIDWORKS. Now here we will create shaft for spur gear assembly. So there are two types of shaft. Go to file, new, part. Okay, now we are in the SOLIDWORKS interface. That's it. Now here we will create shaft. Image quality higher. Now let me choose your front plane. A sketch, choose circle and start with origin point. Okay, now let me define the diameter. Now here diameter it's 50 millimeter, and simply extrude. Keep end condition here mid plane, because we want to expand in both direction, 140 millimeter. Look, okay. Now at the mid we need to create a keyhole. This is the way what shaft looks like. Front plane, a sketch, normal. Let me choose here center rectangle, and here you will find a center point. See, okay, let's draw 12.5 millimeter, the same vertical length also 12.5 millimeter, and if it is not fully defined, so this is 25 millimeter, and choose this point, hold shift key and select this point, and you will define. Okay, still the drawing is not fully defined, so let's make vertical. Okay, that's fine. Now it is fully defined, so just simply tilt it. Go to feature and select extruded cut. Now keep here mid plane and condition, and we want to keep the slot not full length. Let's keep it 162 millimeters. See, okay, that's it. Let's define some material or appearance. Steel, that's fine. Now let me save. Go to desktop, create folder, spur gear assembly. Now here let's save this one, shaft 1. Save. Now shaft 2 also we will create with the help of this one. So simply we will do select this one and directly click this dimension, keep 30 millimeter. Okay, click refresh. Now see, now this one extruded cut, so simply select sketch, edit sketch, normal, and here we will change dimension, keep 7.5 millimeter, and this vertical also 7.5 millimeter. See, exit. Now this is perfect. Even if you like, you can give simple chamfer here, 1 millimeter, delete, select both these faces. Okay, now click here save as, don't save, save as, and this one keep shaft 2. That's it. Let's make the pins for this shaft. Now here we forget to do one thing, extruded cut, edit extruded cut, and the length we will keep 55 millimeter. That's it. Okay, now save again. Shaft 2 created. Let's go to pin. Let's start to create the pin for both the shafts. So let me start with front plane. I'll choose here center rectangle and draw a rectangle from origin point, and let's define, use smart dimension, 12.5 millimeter horizontal and vertical also 12.5 millimeter, and choose extruded boss base. Keep here end condition mid plane, and we how much the length of our shaft cutout is 62, so pin length also we will keep 62 millimeter. Okay, we will give some different colors so that it will be identified during okay, let's keep as it is. Save, and this one pin one. Now choose here edit sketch, 7.5 millimeter, this one also 7.5 millimeter, exit. Now the length we need to change, so choose this one, edit sketch, and length here change 55 millimeter. Okay. Now let's save as it is. Save as pin number 2. Save. Now let's go to start assembly of spur gear. Let's start to create the assembly of spur gear. Spur gear we will took from toolbox. Let me choose your file, new, and we will choose here assembly. Okay, now we are in the SolidWorks interface. Let me cancel this one, plain white. Now let's create one geometry first, then later we will insert. So let me choose your front plane, a sketch, circle, and let me start to draw two circles. Connect both the circles, exit, choose this line horizontal. Now select both the sketches tangent. Let's define. This length we will keep 594 millimeter, and the smaller one 115.5 millimeter. Just check by default, that's it. Now exit. Now it's time to bring our spur gear. So how we will do this one? Go to design library, choose toolbox. If you don't have toolbox, just click add-ins, go to option add-ins, and here you will find toolbox. See, toolbox library, check both the boxes and click OK. Now we will go to NC metric, power transmission gear, and here you will find spur gear, so just drag. The first gear we will keep a smaller one. So profile, it's 5.5. It is pre-calculated, so I'm just telling the dimension, exactly what dimension we are going to take it. Number of teeth. So number of teeth we are going to choose for smaller gear, 21. Pressure angle we will keep 20. Face width 55 millimeter. Hub style we will keep as normal, none. And here shaft diameter, let's keep 50 millimeter. See, 50 millimeter. Keyway none. Okay. Now it is asking you need one more, so cancel it. Now right click and make sure it is float. Now it is in floating mode. Oh, that's it. It is in floating mode. You can rotate it with the help of rotate component. Click component and it will rotate. Okay. Now after adjusting, we need to cut first. If you want to edit any dimension for this gear, right click, edit toolbox component, and it will again appear you here. You can adjust. So here we will change one thing. Nominal dimension or diameter, let's keep 30 millimeter smaller. Okay, select this face, sketch, keep normal circle, and let me draw. This is center point 1, 2, smart dimension, and let's keep outer one 86 millimeter and the inner one 46 millimeter. That's it. Now go to assembly, and here you will find assembly feature, extruded cut. We are going to cut, keep depth 12 millimeter. Okay, now choose this part. If you unbox this part, you will find here plane 1, 2, 3. See, okay, this third plane also comes here. There is no mid plane, so let's create here mid plane. Choose face 1, face 2. See, the mid plane is going to create. Okay, once we created plane here, choose plane, drop down this menu, assembly feature, mirror, and here let's choose this cutout. See, extruded cut, plane we already selected. Now you will see the preview here. Okay, now that's it. So our first gear is created. There is one more option. We need to create shaft, keyhole. So sketch, up to here. Now choose center rectangle. Seven point five. Go to assembly, extruded cut. Now this time what we will choose, keep end condition through all, so that it's going to cut through all. Okay. Oh, that's it. Just drag it. It's time to create another gear. Spur gear. This is the biggest one. 5.5 module, and here teeth we will choose 108 millimeter. 8 numbers. See, it's going bigger. Pressure angle same, hub same, and shaft diameter we will keep 50 millimeter for this. And everything same. Okay, let me choose cancel. Now rotate component, rotate it. Okay, now let's do some relation. Keep concentric relation, select this inside circle and this circle, concentric relation. Now this outer circle and this inside circle, now it is also going to make concentric relation. Now again choose front plane, this face coincident, again choose front plane and this face coincident. Okay, now both the gear comes in the particular position. Okay, you can hide this one. Okay, now we need to do some things here. Now here we will make some cutouts. So let me choose this face, sketch, and here I'll choose normal circle, and let me draw two circles. Smart dimension, and let's define this 547.25 and the inner one 150. Go to assembly, extruded cut. Now it's going to cut, so let me choose here depth 18.5 millimeter because overall thickness is 55 millimeter. Okay, now let's create a plane. Select both the faces and you will create a plane at the mid of this plane. Okay, now we created plane 2, so go to assembly feature mirror. Now see plane 3 is selected. Now feature to mirror, so I'll choose this cutout and it will automatically see the preview here. Okay, now it's mirror. Choose this face, sketch, normal. Now here we will create some holes. Now let's draw the for construction purpose. Let me draw here circle. Now let's define this. Millimeter, this outer one 348.625 millimeter. This is roughly calculated, not that. Circular pattern. Now here let me choose this one. We need 6 number of patterns here, clear, and choose this. Now see, it's going to rotate. This is the center point parameters, 0.1, the center point we have to select it, and everything as it is, equally spacing 360 degree. Okay, now let's make a shaft hole also, rectangle, and okay, 12.5 millimeter. Now let me connect from here to this point, exit, choose this line. For construction purpose, again choose the line horizontal and select this outer circle point, coincide. Now it is coincident. Now it's time to extrude cut. Fully defined sketch, calculate. Now see, it is fully defined. Assembly feature, extruded cut, and here we will choose through all. Okay, now that's it. Now it's time to add our shaft and insert component, browse desktop, and we will find our spur gear assembly. You can change. Now let's bring both the shaft, open, 1, 2, choose your mat, shaft and this hole, concentric relation, shaft and this hole, concentric relation. Now go to standard advanced mat width, width selection. First choose shaft both the end. Now tap selection, select this inside face. Now it's going to shift here. Okay, now again we will go to same thing. Let me keep these two faces, then shaft. Okay, that's fine. This is fixed here. Now standard mat, choose this face and this face, coincident relation. Now the same thing we will do it here. Just rotate and find where exactly. Okay, that's it. These two faces we need to coincide. Go to mat, choose these two faces. Now it's going to ask coincide. Okay, now we this shaft coincide with this. Insert component, browse and choose both the pin, open. Mat, choose this face and this face. First check where exactly. Okay, now choose bottom face and choose this bottom face. Okay, now let me select both these faces. Okay, that's it. Now the same thing we are going to choose here. Select this bottom face, this bottom face. Okay, now let me choose this side face and this side face. Okay, now let's check where exactly. Okay, the pin is here. Now choose your distance. Now let make this 55 millimeter and 62. 55 minus 67, 3.5. Okay, so 3.5 is exactly the distance for both side. Okay, now everything is fixed. Now let's add gear ratio. Choose this face, normal, and adjust this small gear. Make little touch. Okay. Hide. This one also hide. Go to Mac, Mat, Mechanical Mat Gear. I'll choose first this one, then second this hole. Now here we need to define teeth ratio 21. This is the first one, and here 108. This one. Okay, okay. Now let's play. Let me save this assembly. Save as assembly. See, it is rotating. You can just simply show. Okay, we will keep to this condition. Save as, rebuild and save. Now we need to create an animation. So go to Motion Manager study up, and here I'll choose motion analysis. If those people don't find motion analysis, just go to add-in, and here you will choose your SolidWorks motion. Okay, now first I'll choose frame, 60 frame per second. Then later I'll choose contact. I'll select these two gears. These two gears going to create a contact. If one moves, another will move. Material not acrylic, it is another, so uncheck this box. Okay, now let's define motor. We will choose this face, 5 revolution per minute. Okay, now let me choose here calculate. Once you select calculate, it will take time to calculate. Now it's slowly calculating. Now just play. See how both the spur gears are rotating. So this is the simple animation how we did in SolidWorks. If you like to save, just click save. Choose your destination, give any name, AVI file, and here you have to fix your aspect ratio. So I'll always keep 16:9, so this is full HD frame 50, and save. It will ask you, uncheck this key. Okay, now once you select okay, it will ask again, it will calculate from the start to end, and it will save in your destination. I hope you like it. So don't forget to share and like our video. If you have any comment, just write down below. We will try to answer each and every question. And please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks and Inventor. And please suggest us if you like any other software tutorial. We will try to make crew parametrics, and we have plan for AutoCAD also. So let's see. Thanks for watching.